Hey there! When creating an e-learning course, we often have a bunch of images that help us tell a compelling story. These visuals are crucial. They engage learners and bring our content to life. But there's a common challenge. We need to edit all these images to fit a particular size and format to maintain a consistent look throughout the course. Let me share an example. I have this set of stock images that tells a story of a woman's journey, making a groundbreaking presentation to her company's board members. She's thrilled about her new idea and is gearing up to pitch it. She confidently presents her proposal, capturing everyone's attention. The team loves it. There are high fives all around, and everyone's applauding her success. And finally, we see the team heading off, maybe planning a celebratory dinner after a job well done. These images are perfect. But here's the thing. These images are all different sizes and we need to make them uniform to fit seamlessly into our e-learning course. So how can we efficiently resize and export them without spending hours editing each one individually? Well, today I'm going to show you a simple and time-saving Photoshop workflow that will help you do just that. First, let's open Photoshop and create a new file. Click File and then select New. We'll set the dimensions to 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 72 pixels per inch, a standard size that's perfect for e-learning modules. If your course requires a different resolution or format, simply adjust the pixel dimensions and resolution here to suit your project-specific needs. Now, choose RGB color mode, and you can set the background to white or transparent. It's totally up to you. Since we won't be using the background layer in the final images, it doesn't affect our process. Setting up the canvas with the correct dimensions ensures all your images will have a consistent size, which is key for a professional and cohesive look in your course. Now let's bring our stories images into Photoshop. I've got these five images of our main character's journey. Select all the images you want to include. In my case, I'm holding down the Shift key and selecting each image. Then, simply drag and drop them into your Photoshop canvas. Photoshop will prompt you to place each image individually, allowing you to position and resize them as needed. This method imports each image as a separate layer, giving us full control over each one. As each image appears, you'll see a bounding box around it. You can resize the image by dragging the corners while holding the Shift key to maintain the aspect ratio. Position it so that the key elements are within the frame. Once you are happy with the placement, press Enter or click the check mark to place the image. Repeat this process for each image. Take this opportunity to crop out any unnecessary background or to zoom into important details. By resizing and positioning each image, we ensure that our audience focuses on the most important elements of our story. With all images placed, let's keep things organized. Head over to the Layers panel. You'll see that each image is on its own layer and named as Layer 1, Layer 2, and so on. Click on each layer's name and rename it to something meaningful. Since we are telling a story, let's name them as Shot 1, Shot 2, 3, 4, and 5. Renaming layers helps keep your project tidy, and these names will be used when we export the images, making it easier to identify them later. Before we proceed, let's save our project. It's always a good idea to save your work in case you need to make changes later. Now comes the exciting part, which is exporting each layer as its own image file. For that, go to File and select Export, and then select Layers to Files. In this dialog, click Browse to choose where you want to save your exported images. I'll create a new folder called Exported Images. Under File Type, you have options. For standard images, JPEG works well. If you need transparency for images without backgrounds, you might choose PNG 24. Since our images are full frame photos, I'll select JPEG. You can also adjust the quality settings if needed. Make sure visible layers only is checked so it only exports the layers we can see. Once everything is set, click run. Exporting layers to files automates the process of saving each image individually, saving you a ton of time. Let's check our exported images to make sure everything looks good. Here they are. Each image has been resized to our specified dimensions and saved as a separate file. Notice how each image is perfectly framed, focusing on the key parts of our story. Before we wrap up, here's an extra tip. If you have images or elements that don't fill the entire canvas, like icons or logos, you might want to eliminate any unnecessary empty space around them. Let's say we have a company logo we want to include. Place the logo on the canvas and position it where you want. Now, when exporting, select PNG 24 as the file type and check trim layers and transparency. This ensures that the exported image only contains the logo itself without extra white space and preserves any transparency. Click run and your logo is exported perfectly. This is particularly useful when you need to use these elements in other programs where extra space could cause alignment issues. And that's it! A quick and efficient way to resize and export multiple images in Photoshop. Perfect for creating cohesive and engaging e-learning courses. This workflow not only saves you time, but also ensures that all your images are consistent in size and appearance, enhancing the overall quality of your course. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions or if there's a specific Photoshop technique or workflow you'd like me to cover next, please let me know in the comments below. I'm always eager to help and share more tips. Thanks for joining me today. Happy designing, and I'll see you in the next video.